Kano APC crisis. Tinubu to meet Ganduje as field threatens 2023 admission. Hello, my amazing family. When is your time? It's your time, and it can only be your time over and over. What is one thing 2021 has taught you so far? I guess I'll be hearing from you guys in the comment section. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. In a move to save his presidential ambition, the national leader of the All Progressive Congress, APC, Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, is set to meet Governor Abdullahi Umar Ganduje over the crisis rocking the party in Kano State. Tinubu had on Sunday met with Senator Ibrahim Shikaru, whose camp has been having a running battle with Ganduje over the control of the party structures in the state. The former Lagos State Governor singled out the leaders of the warring factions in Kano for reconciliation at a time when the just concluded congresses of the party had triggered a crisis in 13 states. The meeting between Tinubu and Shikaru had raised dust in Kano, regarded as the vote bank of the ruling party. The congresses had polarized APC in the state into two, with the governor's camp being shared by Abdullahi Abbas, while Shikaru's faction has Ahmadu Haruna Danzago as chairman. The crisis reached its crescendo last Tuesday when an FCT High Court gave a judgment upholding the parallel Congress head by the Shikaru-led faction and voided the Governor Ganduje faction. The battle between the camps assumed a violent posture on Thursday when talks touched the campaign office of Senator Jobrin I. Barrow. A petition has since been written to the Inspector General of Police, Akali Baba Osman, indicting top shots in the governor's camp, including his chairman. The camp lawyer to Governor Ganduje, led by Abbas, had denied sponsoring the attacks. A stalwart of the party told Daily Trust that Tinubu waded into the matter as part of plans to advance his yet-to-be-declared presidential ambition. The former Lagos State Governor has been romancing with Ganduje since after the 2019 general elections. Tinubu had last month visited an elder statesman, Alhaji Tanko Yakasia, in Kano, where he sought for the northern leader's support towards the actualization of his presidential ambition. Previously, clerics in Kano State had endorsed Tinubu's presidential ambition. The source said internal wrangling rocking the party in Kano State would affect Tinubu's ambition, hence his intervention. Tinubu's interest in all of this is the number of votes that can come from Kano. A good politician cannot play with the number of votes from the state. Lagos and Kano are central to any politician's presidential ambition. Combined votes from the two states are over 2 million, and that is why Kano was determinant of the 2015 and 2019 elections. The source, who is close to Ganduje and Shikaru, said, pleading not to be named. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is your first time. Thank you. Another source said power brokers in the APC, including a section at the center and some governors who are allegedly averse to the Tinubu's presidential ambition, are fueling the feud. You know, some powerful personalities in Abuja have reservations on Tinubu's presidential ambition. Thus, they see this as an opportunity to advance their cause by decimating the camp of Ganduje, the source said. There is a rumored meeting between Asiwaju and Ganduje. Contacted, the Kano State Commissioner of Information, Mohammed Gaba, said Governor Ganduje was also invited by the national leader of the party for peace, Pali. In a phone interview, he said, Tinubu invited the two groups, both Mallam Shikaru and Kano State Governor, to the reconciliation meeting. Asiwaju decided to hear from Mallam first and subsequently hear from the governor, and if there is any reason for reconciliation, then they take it from there. If you look at it politically and historically, there is always a contest or struggle for power after a second term. It happens during Shikaru and Kwakwaso. At the end of the day, whether they are reconciled or not, the election will be conducted and Allah decides whoever emerges as governor, senator, and what have you. Also yesterday, the Kano State Attorney General and Commission for Justice, Barrister Lawan Musa, told Daily Trust that a notice of appeal has been filed against last week's judgment that recognized the World Congress of Shikaru's faction. He added that they have also filed a motion for stay of execution and other motions, which he said they believe will tilt the tide in their favor. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is your first time. Thank you. Let me digress a little. I want to believe that no one can resolve their differences because the governor seems to be stubborn, not ready to carry everybody along. Let's see if Tinubu can do something. And for God's sake, how can Tinubu be this blind to the political machinations of the North, especially when placed vice a vice with his wealth of political experience dating back to decades? Has he not learned anything from what befell his protege, Moshood Abiola? Or was he not the same man the North used to oust a Billy Jonathan? Hasn't he been told that he's just a stooge in the Northern political calculations? I have said this time without numbers, that the Northern oligarchy will not back his presidential ambition. At this point, he looks blind and deaf. Well, for those the gods have doomed, first they will go mad. Very unfortunate for a man of his worth, is still blind to the promises from the Northern people. Anyways, sources in the camp told our reporters that Shikaru went to the meeting without the blessing of other members of his camp. Operating under the G7, the Shikaru's camp has Senator Baru Kano North, Rep. Shiban Sharada, Nasiru Adwa, Tijani Abdulkadir, Jobe, Haruna Issa, Dedere, among others as key members. One of the sources said the former governor was yet to brief them on the outcome of his meeting with the APC national leader. As far as we are concerned, the meeting was personal and not for our group because he went there without our permission, and since he returned, nobody has been briefed. What I can tell you is that nobody can hand over Kano to anyone come 2023. The state is bigger than anybody, one of the sources said. He emphasized that the crisis working the APC in Kano was to solely free the party and open it up to all in the state. As it is now, many people are being sidelined. They are practicing politics of exclusivity, and it is not good for our democracy. Another source said they would meet today. There is a possibility of asking Shikaru to tell the world that he went to Lagos on his own, he said. A member of the Governor Ganduje faction, Engineer Ramat, said the meeting was a sign that the governor's side is winning in the ongoing crisis. Ramat, who is the chairman of Ungogo local government area, said if Tinubu had invited Ganduje, it would have been interpreted as though father and son are combining to deal with Shikaru. Tinubu's media head, Mr. Tunde Rahman, pledged to call our correspondent when his comment was sought on why his boss was interested in Kanu. He was yet to call up till the time of going to press last night. The national leadership of the APC yesterday insisted that the congresses attended by its delegation were authentic. The party also said it was yet to receive any study. The recent High Court judgment recognizing Shikaru's faction as legitimate in the state. Speaking with newsmen on Monday in Abuja, Secretary of the APC Ketika Extraordinary Convention Planning Committee, Senator John James Akpan, said the party did not send parallel state congress committees to the state. "We are responsible leaders of the party and we wouldn't like to comment on a judgment that we have not seen. All I can tell you now is that we are going to apply for a certified true copy of the judgment. We haven't seen it. We need to study the judgment. We didn't give letters to two committees. How could we have done that? We won't put fire in our own ass. We know the people we gave the official letter to go to Kanu and conduct the official assignment. That is the team we will accord recognition to," he said. In a separate interview, Barrister Ibrahim, who led a team that conducted the Congress which produced the displaced Abdullahi Abbas as chairman, told newsmen that the Congress attended by Governor Ganduje was the authentic Congress. There was no comment from Shikaru's camp as the number of his media aide, Mr. Sule, was not going through. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. And to Mr. Ganduje, this guy should resign. For crying out loud, he is old, outdated, and confused. Kanu is not his personal property. That is why he thought he could dethrone a first-class emir just like that. Kanu people should wake up. This is the 21st century, not medieval times. Constitutional authority must be obeyed. These old men should leave the stage for younger ones with futuristic ideas. And as old as Ganduje is, he's the number one master of stuffing dollars, the number one political thug in the old north, like his master in Lagos, the number one political thug. I hear you. You people will continue to destroy yourselves because of the evil you people have done to this country. And to Mr. Tinubu, you should try to forget about your ambition come 2023. Please, if you are new here, there is a bell at the right or left hand. Please just click on it for more updates. And most importantly, tell a friend to tell a friend about Thunderways Media. God bless you. Bye-bye.